In this final video of Chapter 6, we're going to go through bone fractures and fracture healing. Of course, a fracture is when a bone is broken, and if the ends retain their normal position, it's a non-displaced fracture. But if that fracture causes the bones to become out of alignment, that is a displaced fracture. If the bone is broken all the way through, it's complete. If it's not broken all the way through, it is incomplete. If the break is along the long axis, it's a linear fracture. If the break is perpendicular to the long axis across the width, it's a transverse fracture. If the fracture breaks through the skin, it's compound or opened. If it does not, it's simple or closed. We're going to go through these types of fractures here with pictures, so you should be able to describe, or at least if these fractures are described to you, you should be able to determine which one of these it is. And we're going to start with a comminuted fracture. That's when there's three or more pieces or fragments or a shatter of a bone. A compression fracture is when a bone collapses in on itself. You can see the normal height of a vertebra here, where it reduced in height because it collapsed on itself. This happens with severe osteoporosis. Next type of fracture is a spiral fracture, where a bone is twisted. It's a mechanism. The bone is twisted until it breaks. We see that here on the tibia, which is the shin bone. An epiphyseal fracture will occur along the epiphyseal plate, where it is just cartilage. A depressed fracture is a pressed inward type of fracture from some type of blow. Here we see it in the skull. A green stick fracture, like you can see here, is an incomplete fracture. It does not go all the way through the bone. This will happen in children because their bones are more flexible. So as the bone bends, it begins to fracture, kind of like a green stick. If you were to bend a green stick, meaning it still has life in it, it's very bendy, and it might splinter a bit at one end, on one side, like it does here. In an older person, bones are much more brittle, where if you start to bend it, it would just snap into two pieces. So you see green stick fractures where you see a little bit of bend and an incomplete fracture, and it's most common in children because of their flexible bones. In the last section in this video, we'll go through the stages in the healing process of a fracture. So make sure you know these four stages. Stage one to heal a fracture is hematoma. Oma is a mass. Hemato is blood. So hematoma would be a mass of blood. Here we see a complete fracture, and we get this pocket of blood, which will clot. It's swollen, it's painful. That's stage number one. Stage two in fracture healing is fibrocartilaginous callus forms. Because we have osteocytes, or I should say osteoblasts, in this lining, osteoblasts will secrete osteoid, which is a gel-like substance. Remember, there's no minerals in here or calcium from the diet yet. So this will be just a gel-like matrix or area similar to cartilage, why it's called a fibrocartilaginous callus. Blood vessels start to restore themselves, spanning the fracture as well. Step three is a bony callus. The cartilaginous callus has ossified now. As minerals come in from the diet, it starts to harden, and we get trabeculae. This is almost like the original bone. The only difference is the compact bone on the edges has not formed yet. And the final stage of fracture healing, bone remodeling occurs. So you start to use this bone again, You start to place stresses on it, and now bone will get laid down where the stress areas are. This is remodeling, and eventually the bone that's healed is indistinguishable from the bone around it. So there's your four stages of fracture healing: hematoma, then fibrocartilaginous callus, then bony callus, and finally bone remodeling.